I thought that The Addams Family would be the perfect movie to review for Halloween, but, to be honest, I didn't like this film. This is yet another instance in which a small element of a film became a big problem for me. Dr. Strangelove was more satisfying for its serious moments than its black satire, and the Doomsday Machine made the Cold War setting irrelevant. The Hitchhiker's Guide made light of genocide, and I just couldn't get past that. And now we come to the Addams Family. This time, the characters were the main feature that spoiled the movie for me. I found this bunch of misfits thoroughly unlikable, and therefore couldn't care about them. Gomez and Morticia Addams, played by Raul Julia and Angelica Houston, seem to take a masochistic delight in pain, misery, and the morbid side of life. Their marriage is based on how blissfully unhappy they are, revealing themselves as unhinged and unrelatable. Gomez misses his long-lost older brother Fester, Christopher Lloyd, and loves him for the loathsome, underhanded monster that he is. The Addamses are crazy, but not in a good way, and appear more sinister than mischievous. They keep cyanide and dozens of deadly weapons in the house, and they idolize the murderers and heretics in their family lineage. When your idea of fun involves digging up your dead relatives, rigging dynamite under a boating couple, or stealing road signs so that the cars outside crash, then you're clearly depraved and dangerous. The Addams' pranks and odd, morbid personalities could and would have gotten people killed. Most disturbingly of all, Wednesday, a young Christina Ricci, is constantly trying to kill her brother Pugsley. That's not funny. That's disturbing. And you know what? Morticia encourages her. What kind of sick, twisted people are these? It's as if Bridget from Ginger Snaps never got over her death fetish, moved into a haunted house, and married that depressed kid from American Beauty who videotapes plastic bags. The late Raul Julia has inexhaustible charisma, but even he can't make Gomez safe or trustworthy. Christopher Lloyd is manic and lively as Uncle Fester, and it was nice to see him bond with the Addams children. However, I found him more likable when he had amnesia and forgot that he was an Addams, as I didn't want him returning to this family of morbid psychos. The final half hour is more engaging, as the Addamses turn out to be a closely knit, honorable family. But even this doesn't work. While I did enjoy watching the Addams' zany escapades and the love they shared for each other, I was still deeply unsettled by how perverted and crazy they were. Fester's greedy adopted mother, Elizabeth Wilson, is a suitably despicable villain, and you do want her stopped, but on some level I didn't want the Addamses to succeed either. You may think I'm humorless in posting this negative review, but I'm really not. Being different should be celebrated, and a sick, morbid sense of humor is often amusing. How else could I have made a Resident Evil joke about periods? But there's a difference between a weird but friendly family and a bunch of unhinged, dangerous, death-obsessed, crazy people. And this is coming from a guy who admires Hannibal Lecter. The film has gothic art direction, brisk pacing, fun gags, and strong performances, especially from Julia and Lloyd, but the high-quality acting could never manage to make the creepy, disturbed Addams Family likable. If you can get over that, then by all means, go see the film. If this were a film adaptation of the 1960s TV show, which featured a nicer, more normal, simply eccentric family, then I would have liked this movie. But as it stands, the characterization ruined a nicely crafted, well-acted movie. Barry Sonnenfeld's The Addams Family earns 2.5 stars out of 5. Thank you for watching. Cheers.
People are strange when you're a stranger. Faces look ugly when you're alone.